I'm going to try and courageously explain to you how the Prime Minister thinks she can turn her Chequers Brexit plan, seemingly everybody hates, into a Brexit deal. I've been talking to lots of senior members of the government, and believe it or don't, they still think there may be a deal. This is what I've learned. So, at the heart of the problem, as you know, is the Northern Ireland backstop, though that is the system for keeping the border open between Northern Ireland and the Republic in all circumstances. There was, in the view of officials, a bit of a breakthrough in talks, although you wouldn't believe it given the seemingly bad feeling between the rest of the EU and the UK, where Michel Barnier said that any checks on goods flowing from the mainland of Great Britain to Northern Ireland could be done in a lowish key way by British officials away from the border. That has allowed Theresa May to consider the possibility of rules in a backstop that apply to Northern Ireland alone rather than for the whole UK. Now, at the moment, there are already checks on things like livestock going from Great Britain to the to Northern Ireland. There are separate agricultural rules for Great Britain and Northern Ireland under the Good Friday Agreement. So, in theory, it wouldn't be the greatest of all leaps for there to be separate regulatory rules for goods and checks on goods flowing from Great Britain to Northern Ireland. But under the Good Friday Agreement, those checks, those new checks, would require both communities to consent to them in the form of agreement by the DUP and Sinn Féin. DUP, as you know, propping up this government. I have to say, I haven't the faintest idea how they would get that consent, given that Northern Ireland Executive is in abeyance and there's absolutely no sign of the Northern Ireland Executive being reformed, but apparently the government does have some kind of cunning plan to get agreement from communities for that. That is something that I think the government will offer the rest of the EU in the form of Michel Barnier, the chief negotiator. What they won't do, however, they say, is allow proper customs checks on goods flowing between Great Britain and Northern Ireland. But customs checks are really important to the EU because they are terrified that if we do free trade deals with the likes of China, China will dump lots of cheap goods in Britain and then they'll flow to Northern Ireland and go across the border from Northern Ireland into the rest of the EU. And this would be in some way the UK completely undermining the integrity of the European single market, that the single market would expose itself to unfair competition from the countries that the UK wants to do trade deals with. So it does want, the EU is desperate to have so-called rules of origin checks between on goods flowing from Great Britain to Northern Ireland. Customs checks, they would be just to verify where the goods that go from Great Britain to Northern Ireland have actually been made. Right, hope you're with me so far. So, what I think you can see here is that we are a long way from an agreement on the so-called backstop. There is also a gap on the biggest element of Theresa May's future relationship with the EU, which is she wants essentially the UK to be a part of the European single market for goods, not services, but just for goods, with a common rule book on standards, regulations for goods. Rest of the EU a bit nervous about this because they think that it would give the UK an unfair advantage in services, and they don't think there is such a sort of distinction between goods and services. So, you know, if they let the UK have this common rule book for goods, they think somehow manufacturers that also do a lot of services will be able to undercut European firms. So it is possible that they will say to Theresa May they would rather have Boris Johnson's preferred Canada-style free trade deal, which they may say to her, oh my goodness, like Boris Johnson, that she should chuck Chequers. She's waiting to hear from them. I'd be slightly staggered if they make it as explicit as that. And I have to say, when I speak to her people, she's in no mood to chuck Chequers. I don't think it would quite be over her dead body. But, you know, if the rest of the EU say they don't like common rule book approach. I think she probably would chart check it, but I'm not betting a lot of money on it at the moment. What are her red lines? These days, they are boiled down to two very general issues. She wants to honour the referendum result, whatever she thinks that is, and she doesn't want to break up the UK, as we've discussed. If she gets a deal in October or at an emergency summit in November, which is possible, she would then move incredibly fast to the so-called meaningful vote in the Houses of Parliament to ratify a deal. There'd be an assessment paper days after the deal with the EU. There would then be 5 days of debate in the House of Commons. Goodness only knows, frankly, right now, whether or not her deal would get parliamentary assent. But that's the PM's plan. Will it work? I don't know. It's going to be hairy if it doesn't work. Maybe a referendum. Don't think there'll be a general election, but, you know, it's all very, very messy now, and it's going to continue to be very messy.